In the previous video, we had created the single post page. This is how one of the posts looks like. It displays a featured image, title, description, and the post content. The featured image is unique for each post set from the WordPress admin. However, I missed a few crucial things in that video. First, it's not showing the date of publishing or even the last modified date. A blog post usually requires that. Second, the content area looks cramped. It has no formatting at all. So we have to add some spacing between paragraphs, style, list items, adjust text size for headings, etc. Posts can also have images inserted in them with captions, so we have to properly style them as well. Although this sample post contained only some dummy paragraph text, real posts often contain diverse elements like images, headings, hyperlinks, etc. And you might already know that the WordPress editor allows a lot of formatting. However, I'm not gonna implement all of that in this video. Instead, I will just style some of them. Okay, let me first go to the WordPress dashboard to edit one of these posts and add some elements. This is the post I'm gonna edit, how to choose a hiking backpack. So open it in the editor. Remember, WordPress treats elements as blocks, headings, list, images, etc. or all our blocks. Let's add a few hyperlinks first. Links are not separate blocks, just normal anchor tags within paragraphs. Okay, let's add one more. Then I will add a list element. I think three items are enough: item 1, item 2, and item 3. Okay, we can add an image also. Open the media library and select an image that's already uploaded. Let's give it a caption. Hills and valleys. Okay. Click the update button at the top to save the changes. Coming back to our Next.js frontend, refresh the page so that the dev server fetches the new data from the WordPress API and renders it. The changes are showing up, but no formatting at all. So let's go to the editor and open the main.css file. Search for main.css, and as you can notice, now it contains only the default CSS styles. There are three layers of classes: base, components, and utilities. That's how Tailwind CSS is organized. The base layer can be overridden by components. Components can be overridden by utilities. That's how they are stacked. We are adding some custom rules which need not be overridden, so we can extend upon the utilities layer. Tailwind gives a directive called @layer to add CSS to one of the layers. But why add custom CSS at all? Why can't we just use the built-in class names directly to style the elements? The answer lies in our route file. We are setting the inner HTML of the div element directly. So the only way to style the inner HTML element is to set a class for the parent element and use that to target the children. And here I have set the parent class name as postContent. Okay, back to our utilities layer. Let's add some spacing between the paragraphs. So the CSS selector is .postContent p, then call the apply directive to attach the required Tailwind classes to it. PB4, that is padding bottom 4, will be enough. Okay, with the spacing in place, the text has become a lot more readable. Now let's increase the text size a little more. I think text LG will be sufficient. Next, we want to style the hyperlinks. Class post content A, apply underline. Since they are links, set the text color to blue. Yeah, the links have become visible. We can also set the hover color to slightly darker. Text blue 600 will be enough. Now comes the list items, post content UL. Apply padding bottom PB4. list style type disk list position inside. The default was outside. Also change the text color to something else, for instance yellow, to make it stand out. Text size, text LG. Let the color be 600, a little darker. As I already said, we are considering only the most commonly used elements like paragraphs and lists, but real blogs often contain a lot more diverse and complex layouts, including tables, video embeds, etc. Adding styles for all such possibilities is not practical in this video. Anyway, let's consider a few more. Here is our image. It also has a caption at the bottom. WordPress outputs images inside the figure tag, while the caption goes inside the fig caption tag. So post content figure. As we did above, apply some padding. Okay. Now for the figure caption, we want to center the text. So apply the class text center. Also give some vertical padding, PY2. Okay. Blog posts often contain headings and subheadings. Let's consider that as well. Currently this post has none, so let's insert some headings. Back to the editor, add a heading block and let the text be sample 1. It's an H2 heading. Add one more, sample 2, an H3 heading. Update the post, come back and refresh the page. The heading texts are showing up, but no stylings. Again, back to the main.css file, post content H2. Text size XL. Vertical padding 2. Padding 4, margin bottom 4. Increase the text size to 2XL. Okay, now we have the H3 heading tag. Change the text size to XL. Okay. I think that's enough for the formatting part. Next, we want to add the post modified date below the title. For that, we have to open the route file, that is post/slug.js. Below the H1 heading tag, add a new div, posted by Abhinav, last updated on. Keep it like that and let's add the class names, pb4, text slide 100 and z index 10. Okay. Now for the modified date, if we try to output it as it is, post data dot modified. It appears like this. It's not that readable, so we want to convert the format to a more readable one. We had done that already when we created the blog index page, so just repeat the same thing here as well. We had created a custom component called date.js, in which we used the date.fns library to change the format of the given date string. So import that component to the current file. Now replace the raw output with the date component. And pass the date string as a prop. Date string equals variable post data dot modified. Okay, now that looks good. January 12, 2023. Yeah, that's our single post page. In the next video, we will create the about and contact pages.